This Raw Vision video is brought to you by Metro Solar, proud partner of the Richmond Football Club. G'day Tiger fans, welcome to Raw Vision, and it is the spotlight on round three. The Tigers are heading up to the Gabba on Saturday night to take on the Brisbane Lions. And as always, I'm joined by Brendan Lade to have a look at this week's events. But Lady, I thought before we get into this week's show, I just want to prove to everyone at home that we do make mistakes on this stellar broadcast that we have. Just have a look at this footage from last week. Yep, the other matchup that I think may eventuate, Ricky Martin.
You should have kept going with that. That would have been good. And Billy Piggin.
Oh, Billy Piggin. What do you reckon, Lady? Will we bring Delta Goodrum in this week as well or not?
No, mate, we won't be doing that.
Oh, jeez. Ricky Martin, I don't know what I was thinking there. But anyway, let's get serious here, mate. A few changes. We've had some injuries in the last week, but some good ins as well. And it's great to see Chris Knights back.
Yeah, look, his VFL form's been outstanding. He's had three really good games, coming off a pretty serious injury. So, look, we're looking forward to getting him in the side and see what he can do at the top level again, and hopefully gets through a game and kicks some goals for us.
Beautiful. And he'll play at half forward, you'd assume?
Yeah, he'll play a little bit through our midfield, but yeah, mainly through the half forward line.
Now, Shane Edwards, a late withdrawal last week. We certainly missed his clearance work and I guess forward line pressure. You'd be rapt to have him back in the side.
Yeah, Shane's probably an underrated player outside of this club, but within these four walls, he's highly rated, and we expect him to play this week. And look, he'll add to our forward line, like you said, the pressure, but also he can go into our midfield and give us something a bit different.
I love this in. Dave Asprey has the worst luck of anyone in the AFL, I reckon, but great to see him in for his first game this year.
Yeah, he'll come in and obviously play a bit of defence and help Rancey and Chappie out. We just tell him not to go down to the beach the next couple of days, get away from those stingrays.
Hey, could he play up forward, Dave? He came into the AFL system as a forward.
He probably could. He he was a forward when he got drafted as well. Yeah. He played forward and back, so that could happen at some stage.
Yeah. Well, we're having a look at Brisbane's strengths, and I think they're forward half little guys, the Mosquito Fleet, as we call them, Green, Zorko and Taylor. They're going to have to rely on these guys to kick goals and pressure up because they've lost close, obviously, with that knee injury.
Yeah, well, all three of them are very dangerous in that forward 50. You add Christensen to that lot as well. It's a very attacking half-forward line. They kick goals, they put pressure on. When they do get an inside 50, they are very good at keeping it in there. So we have to be on our guard, but make sure we get that ball out cleanly from our D50.
Yep, you mentioned Alan Christensen, one of the new faces in the Lions this year, and Dane Beams. They've added a bit of class and... Now, both of these guys, well, Beams is an A-grader and Christensen potentially could be.
Yeah, definitely. Christensen at Geelong was one of their better players, obviously in a good team. So he definitely adds to their mix, and he's running into some form at the moment after not having a big pre-season. And as everyone knows, Beams, All-Australian, played in a premiership. So he's a very, very good player and someone we have to watch during the night.
Do you sit on him or do you go one-on-one? What do you do there?
Probably a little bit of both. We have some plans for Danny in place and we have some plans in for us, so there'll be a bit of fun.
Definitely. One of the things I like about Brisbane and when they get up and going is they're run and carry. As we look at this footage here, Lady, this is what they want to do. They want to run and link with hands through the half-back line.
Yeah, definitely. You see Green right up the ground there. They bring their half-forwards up and, open up a lot of space behind their, in their forward line. So we've got to stop these at the source. Don't let it get out into these situations and, put a lot of pressure on and make it hard for them going inside 50.
So you'd be trying to force them to kick from the half-back line, not run and carry?
Yeah, definitely. We don't want these handball chains happening to us. And, we'll be putting a lot of pressure on to make sure that doesn't happen.
You see Adcock coming down from half-back to kick a goal there. So something that we really need to look at. The Daycore key matchup this week is the big boys in the middle, Ivan Marek versus Lewin Berger, and of course Stephen Martin will go in there as well. So he's going to have his work cut out, big Ivan.
Yeah, he's got a big job this week against both them, and it's a bit different up in the Gabba with the centre bounce. It goes very high on the cricket pitch, so Ivan generally plays very well up there against Lewin Berger, and they had a good battle against Stefan last time, so that was good.
So with that, with the centre wicket and it going higher, have you had to do some work with Big Ivan this week?
Yeah, we'll throw some balls up a train a lot higher, so that'll be interesting. But look, it's just important that our mids are doing their body work at the right time.
I thought with this being the Daycore key matchup this week, that we'd have a look back into the archives and look at some fantastic ruck work here, Lady. Now, this is over at Footy Park a number of years ago now, Richardson v. Lade. Just talk us through this ruck work.
Yeah, that's is that me landing on the ground there?
No, that's
I'm trying. I'm actually trying to hurt you there. I'm really trying to hurt
here,
you.
So what happened here, lady? I've put you on your behind there, and Tucky's run away with a clearance.
Well, I was a newborn horse a lot of the time, mate. So you see there, you're already. The screen's not big enough, is it? Maybe another three screens. You're already well in front of the ball, aren't you?
I think I'll mark that inside 50. I'm really happy.
No doubt.
No doubt.
I didn't know there was a second one where neither I came out on top. No. That's good footage. Well, good luck this week, mate. Thanks, mate. Need to improve up at the Gabba.
Yep. We will. Look, we're disappointing last week, and we've addressed a few of those issues. So we expect a pretty good showing against Brisbane.
Looking forward to it, lady. Good luck. It's the Gabba, Saturday night, the Tigers and the Lions. A lot of Tigers supporters in southeast Queensland. Get to the Gabba, we'll see you there.